welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. And today I have another Kentucky Straight Bourbon on my cask. And it's a very interesting Kentucky Straight Bourbon because it's a Kentucky Straight Bourbon with 62.7% ABV. That's about 125.4% proof. That's a lot. 125 proof is a lot. And yeah, it's barrel strength. And they market it as like uncut. So, I think it is not chill filtered. You can see a little bits because it's a bit cold in here. It was cold. And yeah, so it's the barrel strength batch number 5. And it's a beautiful bottle. It has that glass, not engraving, but molding in with Bulleit Bourbon. And the label is actually made of cloth. So that's really, really nice. What do we know about the bottle? We know that it's a Kentucky straight bourbon whiskey, so 51% corn. We know straight means from one distillery, and it is at least 2 years old. And they're going quite strong in flavor, I've heard. So they're really for strength and flavor because they market this as a whiskey for mixing. And just saying this, this bottle costs in Europe around 90 euros. That is about $100, $105, something like that. So very expensive stuff. If you'd mix something with that bottle, that must be at least a very expensive whiskey or expensive cocktail. But let's see if it's worth it. Problem is now, this has 62.5% ABV. 62.7% ABV. That's quite a lot. So if you're a beginner, don't drink it neat. Really, just don't. If you're an expert, there is a technique, the breathing technique, when you breathe out while you have it in your mouth, you can cool your mouth. You will not get burned that heavily by the alcohol. So you can flavor it neat as well, but not quite recommended. Not quite sure if I do it today. So, wow, it's very, very strong on the oak side. A little bit of sweetness in there as well, but very strong on the oak side. It really feels like a walk through the woods. Or even the lumberyard. So it really has that smell from when I was at the cooperage where they cut the wood for the first time, where they did it's called the quarter cut. Yeah, that's what it smells like. Really a strong oak flavor. No, they didn't do the quarter cut there. They stored the wood from the quarter cut there. And then they processed it into the staves and everything. I love it. It's a strong oak flavor. That's the dominant culture here. A little bit of sweetness, little bit of apple touch, but they are just notes, hints on the side. So it's not your typical whiskey, not your typical bourbon. Whiskey can be everything. It's not your typical bourbon. It's a very strong and hefty bourbon. So let's try it neat. Oh, it's as strong as it is in the smell. It's really has a lot of oak, but it's definitely American oak. Sure, they're just gonna use fresh American oak as they always do for their bourbon. It's wonderful fresh American white oak, and tons of it. They have a sweet undertone. Can be considered a little bit sticky, but that's not the main theme here. The main theme is really oak and a little bit of spiciness, but smidge of bitter sweetness, chocolate, something like that going on. A little bit dry, but not as strong as the others. So it's the main topic here is oak, and I think that's what they wanted to serve, as they are aiming for the cocktail industry, that the bartenders use it as an ingredient and say, okay, I have a very, very strong oak flavor here, and I can use that to influence my cocktail in a very direct way. So usually when you have a balanced bourbon, I would say, you have some flavors of every direction. Not with this one. This one has very, very strong influence of oak in just that direction. Let's see how it works out with water. I've added a bit of water. The smell is a bit less intense. It's a bit fresher, a bit sweeter, but still heavy on the oak. Oh, I don't do watering down a lot. It's still at least 52%. And still strong oak. So watering down a little bit doesn't change it much. Which is good, so you can water it down, have more from the bottle, and get the same flavor. Because I think neat is very nice from the flavor, but a bit, yeah, you have to invest too much into thinking, breathing, and being careful with the liquid to have a nice, enjoyable drink. Now I think I've hit it right at the drinking strength, somewhere around 45, 43, 40 even. Maybe I'm just a bit resistant to the alcohol because I've tried 60% now. Little bit less intense, so there's less intensity with the oak. But still the dominant culture, so it's not turning very fruity like other bourbons or Scotch whiskies that you add water to. It's amazing. It's a very, very oak heavy whiskey. So Bulleit Barrel Strength Uncut, tastes like a barrel from the inside. Yep, that's it. That's the reason I can find out from this bottle or from this tasting. And it's amazing. It's nice. It's really nice. Is it worth 90 euros? Arguably. You can. It's a very nice bottle. You get a lot of out of it because you will have to water it down quite a lot. So you get pretty much 1.5 times what you buy. So it's about two-thirds of the price. Could be worth it. So if you really like the oak flavor, oak heavy whiskies, then this might be the one for you. Or if you have a business of mixing cocktails and you have very sophisticated customers that pay high prices for really premium cocktails, this is the right stuff for you. So yeah, that was it. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.